Are we at the beginning of an AI-powered tech utopia, or is it all just smoke and mirrors? Today on AI News, we're taking a closer, slower look into several new robots entering mass production in 2026. Starting with this video of Xpeng's Iron, its newest humanoid robot, and it just released this a week and a half ago, roughly, and they had to cut off the clothes to verify that it wasn't a human in a suit. Now they've released this new video of the robot walking its catwalk in a straight line, something that hasn't been done by other robots so far. And in just a second, I'm going to show you it completely unclothed. But first, let's take one more look at this video in slow motion to see what we can notice from the 82 joints. Remember, this is 5 feet 7 inches tall, or 1.7 meters. It weighs 154 pounds, or 70 kilograms. What you're seeing here is the female version, but it also comes in male. You can get it in different weights, being fatter or skinnier. Features 4 degrees of freedom in its bionic shoulders. This is something that hasn't been done before, as claimed by Xpeng, which is why you get this type of a gait, this catwalk, with one foot in front of another. But here's a view from the front of the Iron robot. This is without clothes or hands. This is after they cut open the leg. You can see down at the bottom the legs and the pistons there. And people have been asking what is in the back of the robot, specifically in the buttocks. Some people interestingly said that it could be someone with prosthesis. So someone who may not have all of their limbs would be packed into the suit, and then possibly their leg or arm is removed for the demonstration. Although others stated that it was clear that there are robotic components inside of the humanoid, as you can see from the rear view. But once again, looking at the front view here, if there was a human inside, wouldn't you expect that you'd likely be able to see at least the hands? Meanwhile, people online said that if Xpeng really wanted to clarify that this was a robot and not a human in a suit, they could simply unzip the robot. You can see there's a zipper going all the way up the leg, up to the hip, and up the back. People said that they could just remove this and then show the interior of the robot. At the same time, other people suggested that removing all of Iron's clothes would completely expose its inner trade secrets. But what if this is all part of Xpeng's marketing plan to build up hype around the robot, slowly revealing it part by part? It's almost seeming like day by day they're releasing bits and bits more of footage of this robot, so we might get there pretty soon, seeing the entire robot stripped down, walking, and even removing specific parts and continuing its operation. But tell me down below how much this should cost, and if it's even ready for production, or if this is just an animatronic toy that's more suited for something like Disneyland. But another competitor named Ubtech just finished what it claims is the first mass delivery of S2 humanoids to its business partners. And it's tough to say how many robots are in this clip, but it is a legion of robots, and this brings up several questions for the future. Specifically, will different countries have regulations for which humanoids can enter and operate within their borders? Much like you have different cell phone networks, GSM, CDMA, etc., and these different networks support different phones from different countries, will there be technical guardrails to contain the robot's operation within its borders? But when it comes to specs, this robot stands at 176 centimeters tall, or about 5 feet 7 inches. And it weighs 70 kilograms, or about 154 pounds, with 52 degrees of freedom. And it features 11 degrees of freedom in its hands, with 6 tactile sensors. And as for its gait, not nearly what the Xpeng's Iron looks like, but it walks at 2 meters per second. And a single hand grasp capacity of 7.5 kilograms with finger grasp of 1 kilogram. and it can continuously operate thanks to its hot swappable battery. In fact, it has two that it can change by itself autonomously by just walking up to the charger in under 3 minutes, meaning that it can operate 24 hours a day. And as for the price, it's tough to know exactly what the range is, but it's been specified to be anywhere between $9,000 to $80,000 or more US dollars. Although this specific model looks like it's not quite ready for the home, maybe just for the industry for now. And finally, Unitree is introducing something interesting called embodied avatars using its G1 humanoid robot. This is simply teleoperation, but the question is, what can this be useful for in the real world? Because so far, these robots are still learning. It seems to be most of them are teleoperated. So the question is, what can be done beyond just boxing or other theatrical performances that is genuinely useful in the real world with teleoperation? Right now, they're just showing some demos of dancing. There were some other demos showing TikTok dances where it was using imitation learning to follow along. Here, it's doing some house cleaning, somewhat useful. It would be good to know what is something that you could possibly have it do just with imitation learning that it could learn. Maybe washing dishes would be one of the first things, but there has to be something more that this robot can be applied to beyond just these tiny little tasks that can be done in seconds. And this is teleoperation, but it suggests that in the near future, you could have artificial intelligence through imitation learning, reinforcement learning, autonomously doing all of your house chores for you while you're away. That would be useful if you could just have the robot do everything that needs to be done without even needing to tell it what it needs to do. That's the question. Can it figure out that it needs to bring you the cup of water? How can it learn your schedule? What to do for you? What fruits do you prefer? What chores are useful? Tell me down in the comments below, what would be the most useful chores that this robot could do out of the box to justify its price tag? Anyways, like and subscribe, check out this video here, and thanks for watching. Bye.